Good day guys, welcome back to our Kotlin programming tutorial. In this video, we're going to discuss about arrays in Kotlin. So far, in our previous examples, we use only variables that can store one value at a time. Meaning whenever we want to get store and hold a particular value, we need a specific variable for each of those values. Like on our example where we compute the average grade based on the given three grades. Now what if we want a variable that can store multiple values at the same time? And we use it whenever we want. This is where the array can help us. So the first thing that we need to discuss is about array declaration in Kotlin. You can declare an array by doing like this, typing the var names. So the names is the variable name, and then the keyword array, and then the type string, which is enclosed in less than and greater than sign, is equals to array of then our initial value. So John, Maria, and Susan. Okay, so looking at this code, I know this is like a lot of code. So let's dissect it. So you're already familiar with the declarations var here. Then we have a new keyword, which is an array, which is preceded by type string and close in the less than and greater than sign. And then we have a function call on which we specify the values of array. So this is our initializer list. So this is the way to declare a string array with initial values. So here our variable names contains three values, the names of John, Maria, and Susan. They're of type string. But if you want to declare an array of integer values, you can do like this. So var my numbers is equals to int array of then your value. Let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So like so, you can declare a double array like this. So var my grades double array of and then the initial values. So let's say 89.70, 79.84, and 95.89. So you will notice that there are special functions for primitive types like int and double, and others like float, long, and char. It is added in Kotlin so that to avoid the boxing and unboxing of those data. Unlike on our string array, it is an object type and we need to declare it like that so that to specify that this kind of array is of type string. So you have a specified function for integers and doubles and other primitive types, and if you are declaring a array of type object like string, you are doing like this. So now we can access the values in array by means of what we call index. So an array, an index is a sequential address of elements. It starts at 0 to the size of the array minus 1. If your array have a length of 5, it starts from 0 to 4. That's why it's minus 1. So it's, you cannot access the value in index 5 because the index starts at 0. It means that for our string array, the name John is located at 0, the Maria is at 1, and Susan at 2. To access the value, we can do something like this. So var name of John is equals to names, and then open and close square bracket, and the index number, which is 0. Then let's print the name and run the program. So this code is getting the value inside the location 0. In this case, the name is John. Then we print the value. We can also edit a particular value inside the array by doing something like this. So names, then the index of the value that you want to edit, and then the value. So this line of code overwrites the value John with a new string value, which is Connor. We can do this as long as the array is declared as var. So remember that our string array names is declared as var and not val. So if you don't want the content of your array to be changed, use val instead. You can also use the values of your array on a computation. So let's say you want to compute the average on values stored in my grids array. You can do something like this. So var average is equals to my grades index 0 plus my grades index 1 plus my grades the index 2, then group it in open and close parenthesis, then divide that to the size of my grades, so my grades dot size. So the size property of the array returns the current size of that array. So here I access each of the values in the array and then divide it by the number of its values by accessing the property of array, which is size. Then let's print the value. So print average. Now this construct is a little bit tedious to do. Usually accessing the array is being done using the loops. So remember loops, we have discussed it previously on our looping and Kotlin video. You can check the link below. So to iterate on all items in the array, we can do something like this. So for name in names, then print name. So we are using print line, okay? So here we have a variable name, and it will be, so the type of variable name will be string, since the array that we are iterating to is a type string, which is the names. As you can see, we don't need to access the value using the index. Each iteration, the array is passing the value to name, and then we can use a value of name inside the for loop block. So let's rewrite the computation of average using the loop. This time we are using the while loop. So let's declare first our counter variable. Var counter is equal to 0. Var sum double is equal to 0.0. And var average, this type of double, is equal to 0.0. Now the IntelliJ IDE will warning it that the double is redundant, but for our case it's okay right now. You can delete the double if you want and the colon, because 0.0 is automatically inferred as a double type. So while counter is less than my grades that size, so sum plus equals to my grades counter, then counter plus plus. Then average is equal to sum divided by my grades that size, then print line average. So here in our example, you can also do this computation using the for loop, but I'm just showing you that it can be done using the while loop and also the do while loop. Okay guys, so that is basically how you can use an array in Kotlin. So if you have any questions regarding the arrays in Kotlin, just don't hesitate to write it on the comment section below. And please subscribe to my channel to be up to date on these Kotlin tutorials. See you guys.